Dear listener, welcome to my channel. Topic is segmentation. In this video, exercises on discontinuity detection are covered. Let us start with the concept of segmentation. In segmentation, input are images and outputs are attributes extracted from images. It subdivides an image into its constituent regions. The level to which subdivision is carried out depends on problem being solved. Segmentation algorithms are based on either discontinuity or similarity. Discontinuity approach is to partition the image based on the abrupt changes in intensity, that is point, line and edge, which are nothing but high frequency component in an image. Similarity approach is to partition the image based on similar regions according to some predefined criteria. Example are thresholding, region growing, split and merge. Detection of discontinuities. There are three basic types of discontinuities in digital image. They are point, line and edges. Main emphasis is to cover the exercises on point, line and edges. Let us start with the point detection mask. The aim of the point detection is to detect either bright point on the dark background or dark point from the bright background. Mask for the point detection. The all masks for point, line and edge are high frequency mask, that is sum of the coefficient is zero, because point, line and edge belongs to the category of high frequency component. This is the sub image which is represented from Z1 to Z9, Z5 the pixel into the consideration. This mask is overlay on the sub image to calculate the response. Now this 8 should coincide with the Z5. In my previous video, I already explained how to apply the mask on an image. Now we calculate the response for this center pixel, that is nothing but Z5, and we take the mod of that response and compare with the threshold, where T is a non-negative threshold and it is used to detect either two types of point, that is a bright point or dark point from its neighborhood. Next is a line detection mask. There are four types of line detection mask are there. Horizontal, vertical, 45, that is plus 45 and minus 45. In horizontal, all values are 2. In vertical, all values are 2. In plus 45, in this direction, all values are 2. And in minus 45, in this direction, all values are 2. When we want to detect the line in an image, at that time, we apply the four types of mask on an image in a different way. And we take the response, that is R1, R2, R3 and R4, and we check at this particular point whose response is more, that point belongs to that particular line. For example, if R1 is greater than RJ, where J is 2, 3, 4, that particular point belongs to the horizontal line category. If R2 is greater than RJ, where J is equal to 1, 3, 4, that is the response of for that at that point for the vertical line is more, therefore that point belongs to the vertical line category. Again, sum of the coefficient of all the mask is 0. Next is the edge detection mask. Definition of an edge. An edge is a set of connected pixels that lie on the boundary between the two regions. Edge detection mask in image processing are mainly based on the characteristics of derivative, that is a gradient approach, that is difference between the neighborhood. Robert mask is a 2x2 mask, and generally Robert mask is a 2x2 mask, which is the even size mask. And when we apply the even size mask, we are not getting the properly even distributed neighbors. Therefore, it is rarely used in image processing. It takes the cross difference, that is the difference between Z5 and Z9 and Z6 and Z8. Based on this difference, we are getting the two types of mask, Z5 and Z9, 1 minus 1. Remaining coefficient should be 0, as a sum of coefficient should be 0. For Z6, Z8, this is 1 and this is minus 1, and remaining components are 0. We can add the two masks to detect the two, that is horizontal and vertical edges in an image. Next is a Prewitt mask, which is the odd size mask. Here we are taking the difference between Z7, Z8, Z9 and Z1, Z2, Z3 to calculate the X gradient. X gradient finds out the horizontal edges, and we take the difference between Z1, Z4, Z7 and Z3, Z6, Z9 to calculate the Y gradient, which detects the vertical edges. The mask coefficient for the Prewitt mask are this: minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, It is the x gradient which detects the horizontal direction. This is the y gradient which detects the vertical direction in an image. And sum of the two masks is the coefficient of these two masks, that is x gradient and y gradient, which detects the edges in both direction in an image. Sobel mask. The coefficient for Privet and Sobel mask are similar. Only in Sobel mask, more weight is assigned to the pixel which is close to the candidate pixel. Therefore, this is very close to the candidate pixel. Therefore, instead of 1, minus 1 and 1, minus 2 and 2 is replaced. Otherwise, the mask is same as Sobel mask. Again, x gradient, y gradient to detect the edges in horizontal and vertical respectively. This is a mask for the x gradient, mask for the y gradient, and the sum of the two masks to detect the edges in both direction. Laplacian mask is the second order derivative, while Robert Privet and Sobel, they are the first derivative mask. This is the coefficient for the second order derivative mask. Now let us start the problem. Example 1. Apply horizontal and vertical line detection mask on the following image F. Use appropriate threshold value. Assume virtual rows and columns by repeating the border pixel values. Image F is given, which is 3x3. Now we require to make this image from 3x3 to 5x5 so that all the pixel getting the appropriate neighbors. Replicate the first row, replicate the last row, replicate the first column, replicate the last column, and the corner pixels are filled with these diagonal values. In this way, we are transforming the 3x3 image into 5x5 image. After that, we are applying the line detection mask. This is the horizontal line detection mask and this is the vertical line detection mask. After applying the mask, we are getting this result. Now here, we can check that we require to take the mod off of the responses. Now here, this is the response for the horizontal line mask for each point and we are taking their positive values. If we compare, we can check that all the values are, for example, this is 283 response and this is the 2, which is greater. So this point belongs to the horizontal line. This point belongs to the horizontal line category. This point belongs to the horizontal line category. And if we compare all these 9 values and all these 9 values, the response at the horizontal line is always greater. Therefore, horizontal line gets detected. Sometimes we can add this value and we can compare it with the threshold also. For a given image F, 3x3 image is given and we require to simply apply the W1, W2 and W3 mask on an input image to get the output image. This image is from 3x3 is transformed to the 5x5 by applying the pixel replication at border and we are getting this image. After that, simply we are applying W1, W2 and W3 mask. So this is the result of W1 mask, this is the result of W2 and this is the result of W3. Example 3. Derive 8 directional Laplacian filter mask. This is a Laplacian mask. Sum of the coefficient is again 0. Now we require to obtain the 8 direction. To get 8 direction, we move the mask coefficient in anticlockwise direction and we don't change the center value. Therefore, this is the original mask 0 minus 1 0, minus 1 4 minus 1, 0 minus 1 0. Now we move this mask in the anticlockwise direction. Therefore, in the next iteration, that this minus 1 comes this here, minus 1, then 0, minus 1. So we are getting this. Again, we move this mask in anticlockwise direction to get. So in this way, we move in 8 directional ways. And after that, we can find out that there are only 2 variations. One is this variation in which corner values are 0, and second variation in which corner values are minus 1. Detect the edge in the following image using strength and, that is the magnitude and direction of gradient. Use Privet operator. Here the 3x3 image is given. In this example, I have solved only for the center pixel, but similarly we can apply for all the pixel by using the pixel replication method. This is the gradient in the x direction. This is the gradient in the y direction. We require to apply the response in the x direction and the response in the y direction. Therefore, f dash x is equal to f of xy into mxy, that is the image is multiplied with the mask in the horizontal direction. image patch is multiplied with the mask in the vertical direction to get f dash x and f dash y respectively. After that, we add the responses to get the magnitude, and direction is nothing but the tan inverse of f dash y divided by f dash x. This is the image, this is the mask. We overlay this mask on this image, that is, 0 should coincide with this 32. All the values are multiplied and we are getting the response as 22, that is, 32 gets modified for 22, and here this 32 gets modified by 171. Here I have explained only for single point, but by using pixel replication you can do for all the points. Now here magnitude is nothing but the gradient in the response of the gradient in the x direction as well as in the y direction. Therefore 22 plus 170 is equal to 193, and direction is find out by tan inverse of 170 by 22, which is nothing but 7.7 radian. This is f dash x, f dash y, and this is the magnitude, and this is the direction of the gradient. Magnitude and direction is calculated only for center pixel 32. Similarly, by pixel replication at border, 3x3 image is transformed to 5x5, and magnitude and direction is calculated for all 3x3, that is the 9 pixels. Write different line detection masks in an image. Detect 45 line inclined line with the following image Z. This 3x3 patch is given, and we require to find out whether this line is inclined to at 45 degree. Different line detection masks are there. This is for horizontal, this is for vertical, plus 45 and minus 45. We first transform this image from 3x3 to 5x5 by pixel replication method. In this way we are getting this final image. After that we require to apply the mask, that is the horizontal, plus 45 vertical and minus 45. We are getting this result. Now here we are taking the absolute value at each response. So this response is 90, 90, 90 and 180. Now this particular point is higher. Therefore, in this image, this particular point is directed towards the minus 45. But if we take the response of all that, here we can find out the response of this 360, 540 and 360 is greater than all these three responses, that is horizontal, vertical and minus 45. Therefore, the line is directed towards the plus 45. Even we can use the concept of threshold. So here it is not explained, but directly simply by taking the individual change or individual reply of the mask, we can take the decision. A binary image contains straight lines oriented horizontally, vertically at 45 and minus 45. Give us set of 3x3 masks that can be used to detect 1 pixel long breaks in this line. Assume that gray level of the line is 1 and that of the gray level of the background is 0. Now here we require to find out the mask which is in the 4 direction, horizontal, vertical, plus 45 and minus 45. And we require to design the mask in such a way that it is used to detect 1 pixel long breaks in this line. That's why here in between minus 2 is given. So it detects the break here and break here. Therefore it is 1 minus 2 1, 1 minus 2 1, 1 minus 2 1 and 1 minus 2 1. Next, compass gradient operation of size 3x3 are designed to measure gradient of edges oriented in 8 direction. So 8 directions are given. Give the form of these 8 operators using the coefficient value 0, 1 or minus 1. Specify the gradient direction of each mask. Now here, for example, the Prewitt mask is taken, but we can apply for all types of mask. Now here, this is the Prewitt mask, which value is for horizontal direction. The mask is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 and 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. So if we apply this mask, find out the direction which is oriented to the base. If we just change the values of this minus 1, minus, minus 1 at above and below it is 1, 1, 1, it find out the edges which is inclined to this east direction. So here we require to use the one starting location, and after that we just require to move this mask in an anticlockwise direction. For example, this is 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. We are not disturbing the center pixel and just moving this outer value in the anti-clockwise direction. So next time this 1 will come here, 0 will come here. So therefore we are getting 1, 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. It will find out the detects the edges in this particular direction, that is northeast. Next, again we move this 1 point next, therefore we are getting this. It will find out the vertical edges which are pointed to the north direction. So in this way we move the mask in 8 direction and we are getting all 8 direction edges. If we apply this mask on an image, we are getting the direction, we are getting the edges in 8 direction. Next time we again come to the original location. So same can be implemented for the Sobel mask also. Show that Sobel or Privet gradient mask gives the isotropic result only for horizontal and vertical edges and for edges oriented at plus or minus 45. Now here the example is explained with the Sobel, but same can be applied for the Privet. Now what is mean by isotropic operator? An isotropic operator is one which applies equally well in all direction in an image with no particular sensitivity or bias towards one particular set of direction. Means we are getting similar results when we apply the mask to all direction of the images. So this is explained with the example. Now this is the Sobel mask in vertical direction, horizontal direction, plus 45 and minus 45. So this is the Sobel mask. Now sub image is given. The sub image is taken in such a way that it represents the three horizontal edges. This is AAA, BBB and CCC. Now here horizontal edge is present, that is AAA, BBB and CCC. Now what we require to do, we require to apply this mask on the four types of mask on this particular type of images. So this is just simple illustration. For example, how to apply the mask. This is the vertical. Minus 1 is multiplied with C, minus 2 is multiplied with B, because 0 is coincide should be 0 should coincide with the B. Minus C, minus 2B, minus A, and we are getting the result 0. This is clear, because the all edges are horizontal and we are applying the vertical, so there is no vertical edges present, that's why we are getting the result 0. Similarly, we have to apply the horizontal mask. Here we are getting the result minus 4C plus 4A. The response is highest if we take the mod operator, because we are applying the horizontal mask and horizontal edge is present. Similarly, we can apply for 45 and minus 45. And we are here, we are getting the similar results, because after calculation, we are taking the mod of the gradient answer. Now, what we require to do, we take, this is our input image. We require to move this image in four direction. This is the original image in which vertical edges are present. We this modify this image in such a way that vertical edges are present, CCC, BBB, AAA. Image is inclined to the 45 degree and image is inclined to the minus 45 degree. So in this way we are modifying this image into the four direction. Now what we require to do, we require to apply this vertical mask on this four variation. We require to apply horizontal mask on this four variation and similarly the last two mask also. Now see, this is the result. Now I have calculated for one. You require to check the answers. This is the edge direction, horizontal, vertical, plus 45 and minus 45, and these are the edges. Means here on this ABCD edges horizontal mask is applied, on this four images vertical mask is applied, plus 45 mask is applied and minus 45. Now we can find out that when in an image, that is sub image, horizontal edge is present, we are getting the maximum response. At the same time for vertical we are getting 0. For plus 45 and minus 45 we are getting the same result. When we apply the vertical Sobel, at that time for horizontal we are getting the result 0, because there is no vertical, there is no horizontal edge and we are applying the vertical. For vertical we are getting the maximum response, and for plus 45 minus 45 we are getting the similar. And this for plus 45 and minus 45 we are getting the similar result, 0 0, like horizontal and vertical. Similarly, we are getting the result for plus 45 and minus 45. You have to observe this result very carefully, and this is the conclusion from this table. The response of the mask that matches the edge direction is minus 4C plus 4A. So whenever that particular type of edge is present and we apply that particular type of mask, at that time we are getting the highest response. The response of the corresponding orthogonal mask is 0. because for horizontal vertical is orthogonal and 4 plus 45 minus 45 is orthogonal. Therefore, at that time, their respective orthogonal mask is 0. The response of the remaining two masks is either minus 3c plus a or 3c minus 3a. But the answer is same as we are taking the mod of this value, that is absolute value of the response. The sign difference is not significant because the gradient is computed by either squaring or taking the absolute value of the mask responses. So in this way, we can show that the Sobel or Previte gradient mask gives the isotropic result only for these four type of edges. And similarly, I have explained for the Sobel mask, and you can easily check for the Previte mask also. So this is all about the problems of the discontinuity related problems in segmentation, that is for point, edges and line. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video, subscribe my channel. Thank you.